Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given.
On this night, this Christmas Eve, we remember a child who was born to us, Jesus. The story of his birth 2,000 years ago is a familiar tale, read to us since childhood. There was no room in the inn for Joseph and Mary, so the baby was laid in a manger, born in a stable, wrapped in swaddling cloths. On this night, angels sang out proclaiming the child's birth to shepherds watching their flocks by night. An extraordinary star appeared, drawing wise men from the east, bearing gifts. This is a humble story. It is one that appeals to children, to the soft-hearted and sentimental, to the simple-minded, to the meek. Yet, the prophecy spoken by Isaiah 700 years before Jesus' birth proclaims that this child born unto us is the Son of God given to us. A babe in a stable is a humble way to bring hope to a world weary with wrongdoing and burdened by evil.
But God has chosen the foolish things of the world to shame the wise.
Why does God use the simple things of the world, the despised and the weak, especially for this his son? God's son could have been born in a palace, in a setting deserving of a king. Wouldn't this have been much easier for men to believe and to embrace? So why does God choose the foolish things of this world to shame the wise?
So that no man may boast before him.
Yes, our pride could accept a palace, but not a stable. God's plan to use the humble and the lowly makes us relegate this Christmas story to nothing more than picture books for children. It is because a stable does not make sense to us. Our pride wants to figure out all things. We choose to reject what we cannot control or understand. We just cannot accept it.
Yet God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life.
That is the message of Christmas. This is why you were brought here tonight. Are you able to see it? Can you hear it? Come with me and listen carefully to this story. Hear afresh this familiar tale. Set aside your preconceived ideas and watch with new eyes to see who this child truly is. He is Emmanuel, God with us.
Amen.
The Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, a virgin will be with child and bear a son, and she will call his name Emmanuel.
So how can this be? How can this happen? How can a virgin be with child and bear a son? Behold, Gabriel, the angel of announcement sent by God to reveal this mystery before us now.
Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you. Do not be afraid. Mary, you have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end.
How can this be, since I am a virgin?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God, for nothing is impossible with God.
Probably gone to tell Joseph, her betrothed, what the angel Gabriel has just spoken to her. I wonder how Joseph will will react to the news that his virgin wife-to-be is a child.
She is with child. How can this be? By the Holy Spirit, she says? Am I actually to believe this? Impossible! Yet, if this truly is by the hand of God Himself, am I not to believe it? Am I still to be her husband? She to be my wife. What am I supposed to do? Oh Lord, please show me. Oh God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, you are not beyond miracles. I would not oppose my Lord, my God. But this cannot be so. I must send her away. I must send her away.
Joseph is a righteous and a good man. He does not want to expose Mary to public disgrace. So he decides to divorce her quietly. But after this, an angel of the Lord appears to him in a dream and says,
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, for the child of her is of the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to
Augustus has issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone is expected to register in their own town. Well, this means many of us, including Joseph and Mary, are headed to Bethlehem, the town of David, because, like me, Joseph belongs to the house and line of David.
His words cut the silent night. child that you carry is God's own. I know it seems the road is long. We're not that far from Bethlehem. We're all our home and joy begins more than ours. We'll cherish him. We're not that far from Bethlehem.
Phew, this is a long journey. I can only imagine how Mary and Joseph are doing. She is so close to her time. I've heard on the road that the city is full of travelers. I wonder if they've been able to find lodging. Maybe these shepherds have some news.
I bring you good news, great joy, that is for all the people.
life, and the life is the light of men.
Praise to God whose love was shown. Jesus left his rightful throne.
He came on earth.
The Virgin's baby son, all creation praised him. God incarnate, come, come to Bethlehem. Still a to set all people free
from Satan's hold within.
For by the sin of man we fell, by the Son of God he crushed the power of hell. Death we fear no more. Now we stand with strength, with power,
God's sons of God on earth.
Faithful
recognize this one? The shepherds did. Even though they are the bottom of society, uneducated, dirty, and poor, they were able to recognize that this baby is from God Most High. Simeon also recognized this baby. This old man loves God, studies his word, and follows his ways. Knowing that the prophets spoke of a Messiah for God's people who would be a savior for the world, Simeon always keeps watch for God's promised one. The Holy Spirit has revealed to him that he would not die before he sees the Christ, the Messiah, God's son. According to Jewish law, Joseph and Mary are bringing the newborn child to the temple to be presented to the Lord.
Oh, sovereign Lord, oh, as you have promised, you may now dismiss your servant in peace. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all people. A light for revelation to the Gentiles, and glory, glory, yes, glory for your people Israel. Come, come and see the Messiah.
The one greeting them now is Anna, a widow and a prophetess. I've been told she's never left the temple serving night and day with fasting and prayer. Now that she's seen the Messiah, she continues to speak of him to all.
Praise be to God. Everyone, come, look, here, this is the one, our Messiah, the Savior of the world. Come.
Oh, this child is destined to cause the falling and rising of many in Israel. And it will be a sign that will be spoken against, so that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. And a sword will pierce your soul too.
What does your heart tell you when you look upon this baby? When you consider Jesus, what is revealed to you? Like Simeon, like Anna, like the shepherds, do you recognize the Son of God?
He who sees all thoughts and knows all hearts came to earth in a humble fashion. He grew up and became strong and wise, never doing a wrong, never committing a sin. He was perfect. Being in very nature God, he made himself nothing, being made in human likeness. And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on a cross.
Believe the child born to us this Christmas Eve is the Son of God that died for you on the cross.
There was nothing attractive about him.
He was looked down on and passed over.
A man who suffered.
He took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows. He was pierced for our transgressions.
A punishment that brought us peace.
By his wounds we are healed.
We are all like sheep who have wandered off and got lost.
We have all gone our own way.
And God took our sins, all we have done wrong, and put them on him.
He was beaten. He was tortured. And yet, he was silent.
Like a lamb led to the slaughter.
He died without a thought for his own welfare.
Yet it was the Lord's will that he be crushed and made to suffer.
Because he was our sin offering.
He lives, and all who believe in him will join him in eternity.
Because of that obedience, God lifted him high and honored him far beyond anyone or anything ever, so that all created beings in heaven and on earth will bow in worship before this Jesus Christ and call out in praise that he is the master of all, to the glorious honor of God the Father.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
gong has only one part, and it's at the end. And it's just going to be a big boom. Like to have the free gift of eternal life tonight, to know that you're going to go into heaven and be with Jesus, that your sin would be forgiven. What I want you to do, I just want you to simply raise your hand up so I can pray for you. Are any people in here who would like to receive Jesus for the first time in their life? There's hands going up. Father, you have seen the hands that have went up in this auditorium tonight, Lord, and we thank you for each one of them.